The more hits we play, the more hits we get. URLradio.net. Stacy Sturm, and in the studio with me today, we have Lynne Tolley of Jack Daniels. Good afternoon, Lynne. How's it going?
Great, Stacy. Thank you so much for having me.
Oh, I was so excited when Janet called, because I don't want to sound like I'm an alcoholic or anything, but I do love Jack Daniels, and good. I probably drink that more than anything. So,
well, my family, you know, thanks you very much for continuing the profitability of the product.
I think I must have put braces on somebody's kid in your family, or put them through college, possibly. I know it got me through college, so. So you're here in Bismarck for the big Abate fundraiser tonight, right? That's what brought you here in the first place.
Exactly, and Abate is the American Bikers aiming toward education, mm-hmm. and they partner with us in the same thing, which is drinking responsibly. We want our consumers to have a good time, enjoy their cocktails, but always be aware of where they are, what they're doing, you know, have a designated driver, mm-hmm. if necessary. That's really the best way to go. And that's just real important, whether you're on a bike or on a in a truck or a car, you know, it mm-hmm. doesn't matter. It's just... you've got to be thinking about that.
Even if you're just walking around.
Absolutely.
You know? My gosh, people overdrink all the time. So it's good that you're doing this. The thing I love about your website is I tried to check out your website today to see what new was going on, and I had to enter in my age.
Yes.
I had to be of legal drinking age to enter into the website. That's great. A lot of alcohols don't do that.
Oh, we are so careful about that. And when you come to Lynchburg, Tennessee, where mm-hmm. the distillery is located, there's a little shop on the town square called the Lynchburg Hardware and General Store, and they have all the T-shirts and the caps and the belts and, you know, anything you can think of with yeah. Jack Daniel's logo on it. But they will not sell to anyone under 21 years of age.
Yeah.
So even to buy an item with our logo on it, we
wow.
want you to be 21 or older.
That's great. That's good. Yeah. That's good. So then I suppose you've just always grown up around this. It's always been in your family. Did you realize how cool it was from the time you were younger? Like what a cool company your family is a part of?
Absolutely not. Had no idea. Was just, you know, just this kid. I went to college and I didn't even tell anybody I was related to Jack Daniel.
Really?
I didn't know it was a big deal at all.
Yeah.
You know, so, you know, fascinating to me that later in life I would end up working for the distillery. But Lynchburg is a tiny little town of mm-hmm. 600 people.
Really?
And we are an hour and a half south of Nashville. We're mm-hmm. about an hour and a half west of Chattanooga. We're pretty far from Memphis. We're maybe 4.5 hours east of Memphis,
okay.
But maybe an hour north of Huntsville, Alabama, so we're right above the Alabama line. But
okay.
beautiful part of Tennessee, you know, rolling hills, and, you know, you North Dakota folks would appreciate its beautiful farmland, but our mm-hmm. fields are not nice and straight and flat like yours are. You know, we drove in from uh-huh. Fargo this morning, and I know these farmers are so lucky that they just go straight down the field
yep.
and straight back up. Our poor old guys are going around hills and valleys and hollows and all kinds of things. So your farmers yep. have a good life.
It does make it easy to plant, but here's the problem is with the with our state tree being the telephone pole, we basically have no trees. The wind is so crazy. So
yeah.
I think they battle the wind a lot. It gets pretty dry.
Oh.
It gets hot. It gets dry. It's hard to keep those fields wet, too, because they are so flat and open and
nice.
Oh, I
see.
Of yep, course.
That makes sense.
Yeah. So maybe you guys have that little benefit going on as well.
Well, come see us when you come to Lynchburg, this tiny little town. You can tour Jack Daniel Distillery. It's open 7 days a week. Takes a little over an hour to tour it, and it is just fascinating. You know, we love teaching people how we make this whiskey,
mm-hmm.
whether you drink it or not. It's
right.
an interesting story, and, you know, the college kids come and we say it's a lesson in chemistry because
yeah.
it's fermentation, distillation, you know, and it's sort of a fun, interesting way to learn about science. So
that is pretty cool.
Yeah. lots of benefits.
Now, back in the day, during the days of Prohibition, this place where you're sitting right now was Bootleg Haven.
Oh.
I have tunnels under here that go under this building where they used to sneak alcohol in from the train. Yeah, I should almost take you down there. You could feel the prohibitionists.
Isn't that wild?
The alcohol sneakers down there. Yeah.
Well, you know.
All the prostitutes and the alcohol, but the bootleggers used to come under my building.
Oh, my gosh. Well, Lynchburg, Tennessee, yeah. You know, Prohibition was 33 years in Tennessee, so it was a little bit longer. We went dry early and stayed dry late.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, we are still in a dry county. So here we are making this world-famous whiskey, and you cannot get a drink in Lynchburg, Tennessee, where the product is made. And all these people come over from Europe, and they come from California, where they used to go into wineries and, you know, drinking wine.
Right.
And in Lynchburg, you cannot buy a cocktail with Jack Daniel in it. Now, that doesn't mean you can't come to my house and we can sit on the, we can sit on the front porch and drink Jack Daniel.
I bet that's probably one of the coolest drinking experiences ever.
Isn't that fun?
Yeah.
It is fun.
I bet you're like right out of a commercial, aren't you, Lynn? You probably got a big old covered porch, don't you?
I do. With
and you got a
chairs.
Swing on there, don't you?
No swing, but lots of rocking chairs.
Yeah, but you got some old trees surrounding your place.
Oh, big old beautiful trees.
You're like a commercial right now in my head, sitting there with my Lynchburg lemonade.
Hey, it's good. And a little breeze blowing, and the Tennessee is so green and lush. It's mm-hmm. a really beautiful state, so come see us sometime.
Now, also, you've been signing some bottles, too. When you were here in town.
Yes, that's right. I think we're going to a store this afternoon.
Mm-hmm.
Captain Jack's.
Yep, Captain Jack's.
And I will be signing bottles. So love to have some people come by and see me.
Yeah, and
that'll be fun.
Even just a single barrel you'll sign, right?
Oh, yeah, single barrel and Gentleman Jack and, you know, our Tennessee Honey, which is our new product that's been on the market for about a year now, and it's so popular. And, you know, with summer coming up, it's great to put in lemonade or iced tea.
Yeah, it's really, I find it to be smoother,
mm-hmm.
but not overly sweet. It's
right,
nice.
Right.
Yeah, it's good.
It's really nice. And then in the wintertime, when y'all are so cold up here, if you have hot tea. Put a little Tennessee honey in your cup of hot tea, that'd make a nice little hot toddy for you.
Yeah. And you actually have speaking of all these great recipes, you have like a cookbook coming out too.
Oh, I do. It'll be my fifth Jack Daniel cookbook. And I think people know about cooking with wine. They know about cooking mm-hmm. with beer, but they don't always think of cooking with whiskey.
Yeah.
And it's wonderful to cook with, for instance, as a marinade for meat. You know, grilling season is gearing up here soon. And if you have a tough piece of meat, if you put Jack Daniel in your marinade, maybe even Worcestershire and some garlic and,
mm-hmm.
you know, whatever else you want. But it tenderizes as well as adds a special flavor. It's delicious in anything creamy like homemade ice cream, creme brulee. Delicious mm-hmm. in that. We make a dish called Lynchburg candied apples at home, and it's just butter, brown sugar, apples, and whiskey. So delicious.
Yeah, I bet that is good.
Really, really good. So in Lynchburg, any recipe that calls for vanilla, we just use Jack Daniel instead. Really? So if you're making something chocolate or caramel or butterscotch, it's especially delicious in that.
I bet. Do you have a bread pudding recipe?
Oh, yeah.
Of course you do.
And a sauce with Jack Daniel. Yeah. Delicious. I even make my pancake syrup with Jack Daniel.
Yeah.
So I put a little butter and in peach season, I'll put some peaches, slice some peaches in that butter and put a little brown sugar, put a little whiskey on there, and you've got a great waffle topping or a pancake topping.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah.
Now, you're working on a cookbook now, but you have some other ones out too, don't you?
Yeah, this will be my fifth one.
This will be your fifth one.
Yes.
What made you decide to start coming up with recipes? Were you always just sort of cooking with it and decided I should put this in a book?
Well, I run a little restaurant that the distillery owns in Lynchburg, and it's called Miss Mary Bobo's Boarding House,
mm-hmm.
and it's in a beautiful old colonial home. And very historic, and we still serve like a boarding house. So we ring a dinner bell at 1 o'clock, And again, even though it's a restaurant, we cannot serve you a cocktail because that's against the law. We're in a dry county, but we can slip it in your food with no problem. So every day we put a little Jack Daniel in something.
Yeah.
And people just love it. For instance, in whipping cream, you know, we always have lots of wonderful desserts.
Oh, yeah.
And if you're whipping some cream, instead of putting vanilla in there, put a little Jack Daniel in it.
Oh,
just don't get so overly enthusiastic that you put too much because
it,
it deflates your cream. But certainly put more than a teaspoon. You know, you put a teaspoon of vanilla, put maybe a couple of tablespoons of Jack Daniel, and it's really good on fudge pie, for instance.
Now, how you said you know, growing up as a kid, you weren't always involved in your it's your great uncle, right?
Was yes.
Jack Daniel. You weren't always involved in the business. When did you get involved? How did that come about?
Well, I was a nutritionist for a school program. That's what I studied in school. I went to the University of Georgia. And I thought, well, I like food and drink and all that, and so I'll be a nutritionist. But let me tell you, Stacy, that is very boring. I got pretty tired of working with, you know, little preschoolers and trying to get them to eat
vegetables
and broccoli and all of that thing. So I thought, well, what would the distillery need with a nutritionist? Probably not much. But I went by and said, you know, y'all got anything that I can do? And they said, well, we'll let you take care of our VIP guests.
Okay.
So, for instance, our distributors in France might come over, and they would come to tour the distillery. Well, I'd meet them at the airport in Nashville, take them to Lynchburg, which is an hour and a half drive. We'd tour the distillery. We'd eat at Miss Mary Bobo's. And then I'd take them back to the Grand Ole Opry you know, whatever they wanted to do in Nashville. So that was a lot of fun because I was showing off my little town. And then Miss Mary died at 102 in 1983.
Wow.
And they said to me, you have a food background. Why don't you run the boarding house? So I'd eaten there as a little girl my whole life. So it was great to be able to step into Miss Mary's shoes and try to continue that tradition.
What a great fit.
Mm-hmm.
That's awesome. So then what is this new cookbook called?
It is called Jack Daniel's Country Cooking with Secrets and Hints from Miss Mary Bobo's Kitchen.
Okay.
So we tried to put everything we possibly could in there, but everything from cocktails to appetizers, you know, many, many entrees, everything, side dishes from sweet potatoes with Jack Daniel in them that is really good in the holiday season.
Oh, I bet.
And then many, many desserts. So,
what's your favorite thing to cook with Jack Daniels?
You know, anything chocolate. It's some way sort of lends itself to anything chocolate.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, I'm a taster at the distillery, and I taste every
Friday. Well,
that's
a tough job, huh?
Listen, everybody wants my job. When I sit on the airplane with some guy, and we'll be chatting, and he'll give me his card, and it'll say IBM. And I think, I have not one single question I can ask somebody who works for IBM. What do you talk to them about?
Yeah.
And then I'll give him my card, and it'll say, Lynne Tolley, Master Whiskey Taster, Jack Daniel Distillery. And he'll go, oh, my Lord, you're a whiskey taster? How do you do that? You know,
right.
And so he'll have 20 questions for me, whether he drinks Jack Daniel or not. It's a fascinating subject. And so I love talking about being a taster and getting paid to do it.
Right.
Now, here's the unfortunate thing. They will not let you swallow. You have to promise to spit it out between samples.
I can see that.
So you rinse your mouth with water and then go to the next sample.
Taste responsibly.
That's right. Your tongue would get, your taste buds would be fatigued if you swallowed it. So that's right. You have to spit it out.
Well, this is so cool. So you're going to be headed off to Captain Jack's this afternoon.
That's right.
People can pop in and buy themselves some Jack Daniels. You'll sign the bottle with a pen so that they can, and you personalize it for them too.
Sure.
You don't just autograph it.
No, I can put happy birthday, or it makes a great Father's Day gift to
buy one of our beautiful
you know, family of brands. Could be single barrel because it's special. It's our premium whiskey, and we can put your dad's name on it.
Yeah.
happy Father's Day or what? Or Mother's Day. What am I thinking of? Mother's Day is this weekend.
Yeah, Lynn, if anybody needs to drink,
no
I'm telling
kidding.
You, it's the mothers. It
I
really
absolutely
is.
Agree.
Yeah, for sure. Well, it's been a pleasure having you in the studio. You'll be at the Abate fundraiser tonight, right?
Correct.
Having some dinner with the Abate of North Dakota crew down there. Unfortunately, it's all sold out.
Yeah.
It's a good and a bad thing. So if people want to see you now, they have to go down to Captain Jack's.
That's right. Well, tonight our dinner has they're using pork tenderloin and a Jack Daniel's sort of gravy thing. And then our cheesecake has Jack Daniel in it. So two good things to throw a little whiskey in.
Were they your recipes?
No, they came up with them here in North Dakota. So I'll be interested to see what they taste like.
Might be in the next cookbook.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, give us a website if people want to find out some more, Lynn.
It's just jackdaniels.com. Love to have you go visit. You have to say you're 21 years of age, and then you'll get on the website and you find out all about making whiskey and Miss Mary Bubba's in our beautiful little town of Lynchburg, Tennessee. Population 331.
Yeah.
That's right.
That's crazy. And you're probably one of the biggest... You're probably one of the biggest alcohol producing companies in North America.
We're pretty big.
Yeah,
we're
you
pretty
are.
Big. You know, our guys, 375 work at the distillery, but it's 24-hour production. Mm-hmm. So we have three shifts going on. But takes a long time to make sure you got enough Jack Daniel for the world.
That's right.
We don't want to run out in any of those countries.
Well, thanks for coming in. Check out jackdaniels.com. You do have to be 21 years of age or older, though. And check out Lynn this afternoon. Stop down to Captain Jack's and buy Jack Daniels, and she'll sign it for you. And always remember, drink responsibly.
Absolutely.
And designate before you celebrate and all that good stuff. Be smart. Have fun, but be smart at the same time. Being dumb, although sounds fun, is not always fun. It's not. It's fun for about half an hour, and that wears off pretty quickly. All right. We're going to take a break. When we come back, we're going to quick wrap it up with a local news update. Sunny 63 today, tonight clear and 34, tomorrow sunny and 72. Right now, Bismarck and Mandan, it is absolutely perfect out. We are sunny and 53 at urlradio.net.